Good afternoon. We are from Belgium, organization Right to Die in Dignity, more specifically the Flemish part of Belgium. We are very honored to receive the opportunity to speak at this World Congress in this beautiful location, Cape Town, which of many people in our country, it would be a dream to be here. The slogan, Dying with Dignity, My Life is My Choice, is really charming us. Needless to say, the slogan is referring to self-determination. As you might know, Belgium is a secular, profane kingdom. The segregation between church and state is very well defined. From a humanistic perspective, human being is not a means to, but the main goal on its own. When the human being decides about his own life, about his own death, about his own end of life wishes, will he then go to hell? The influence of religions on society in the world is still enormous. During many centuries, science and humanity has continuous and headstrong fights to get cleared from religious dogmas and doctrines. Let's name this the emancipation process of science. For example, Darwin on the domain of the biology. The point we want to make is that currently the latest science discipline that wants to become liberated from religious dogmas are the ethical and moral sciences. In many countries, discussions are currently ongoing concerning ethical, deontological, and moral themes, such as abortion, euthanasia, assisted dying, complete life. Due to migration waves and globalization, we become more multicultural, but also multi-religious society in Western Europe. People often don't understand each other anymore. People talk next to each other, and a kind of religious Esperanto is still far away. As director of a geriatric care center, I had a case of a 79-year-old lady with terminal metastasized cancer, who indicated clearly during a conversation about her own end-of-life wishes that she refused any pain medication. She was very Christian and wanted to suffer as Jesus Christ in order to get a place in heaven. We fully respected, documented, and implemented her wish, taking into account the rights of self-determination. In many situations, human rights and the right of self-determination are constantly being violated. Is the right to self-determination absolute? Personally, I think yes, but as far as you don't harm others. We can ask ourselves, what's the basic of our moral actions? We have to wait until 1948 for the first secular text that could be used as a basis of our moral actions, the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. This text is not being accepted everywhere. To discuss about ethical decisions is impossible without neutrality of the government. It's the government's responsibility to make legislation. It's also the responsibility of the government to ensure that legislation is applied correctly. Anyway, there is a universal human resistance against undergoing pain involuntarily. Nature has given itself an answer on some situations. Just think about creation of endorphins during childbirth. Some human rights can be derived from it. For example, you will not torture. The fellow human who is in need should be helped. Everybody knows the story of Chantal Sibir. However, in many areas, we help our fellow human beings in need. We donate blood massively, but at very critical moments, we often don't help our fellow human beings. The human being, and specifically women and children, need more education. The critical mass will increase. We don't need weapons of mass destruction, but weapons of mass instruction. Innovation has always been a struggle. Innovation has always been a battlefield. Our society is changing constantly. There is no doubt that this innovation is growing exponentially during the last decades. This is due to the exponential growth of information and the globally fast communication powered by the internet. Changes are always leading to resistance. Change is always a conflict model until the big mass is in favor of the change. Belgium is known for its worldwide ethical progressive legislation, but has an individual the right on self-determination in Belgium? Concerning individual human rights, self-determination means that one can determine how one can lead his own life. The individual freedom to decide of one's own dying at the end of life is hardly a subject for discussion. In Belgium, there is a legal framework for this. But the right to self-determination, does it also apply when one wants to determine independently how, where, and when one wants to end life in order to die in dignity? People not sick, not physically and not mentally, but in all rationality, they find for themselves that their life has been lived. They don't expect anything anymore from life, and they don't see any future for them anymore. In short, people that think that their life has been lived to the full, those who are tired of life. The existing legislation in Belgium isn't giving any protection in this case. Only people who suffer unbearable physically or mentally, they can make use of the current law. The results of a poll in Flanders were showing that more than 70% understood the wish of older people who wanted to step out of life. Some politicians are well engaged to start the debate on completed life, but the majority of the politicians are keeping out of the discussion. Legal protection can be acquired when a doctor uses polypathology diagnosis as a reason for euthanasia. Today, a person asking for euthanasia because he thinks his life is completed will be determined as being depressed, and he will get medication for depression. It's even possible that he will be referred to a psychiatrist who is able to determine suffering psychologically. Based on this, he can perform euthanasia. Conversations, talks, debates about completed life and about tired of life are taking place in Belgium, and this since more than 20 years. Let's think about the origin of the pill of Drian. After the publication of the cooperation latest wish in the Netherlands, expressing that they can provide a way or a medication after 6 months membership to end life yourself, the discussion restarted again in Belgium. The latest report of the Federal Evaluation Committee on Euthanasia recommended an urgent study on national level to assess all medical activities and procedures related to end of life euthanasia, palliative sedation, high doses of opiates, stopping treatment, and so on. The committee determined also the lack of communication concerning the correct applications of euthanasia for the benefit of citizens, doctors, and all healthcare providers. A new and clear information brochure will be published about the laws on euthanasia, on patient rights, and on palliative care. Meanwhile, a patient in Belgium still has no legal certainty about the implementation of euthanasia. Doctors have the right to refuse, so the patient has to find for himself an acceptable solution. This is also the case in some healthcare institutions that openly refuse to help their patients with euthanasia, all depending on the philosophical background of the institution. We would like to end this presentation with the objectives of Right to Die Belgium Flanders. We ask more legal certainty for patients by adding to the law an obligation to forward if a doctor refuses to help, and guarantee the residents of healthcare institutions to have a free choice and the right on self-determination concerning their end-of-life choice. As an organization, we want to participate in the debate about the law to gain the rights to help with assisted dying. Extending the euthanasia law for people with dementia. This group of people have no rights to request for euthanasia despite their negative declaration of their wishes that they want euthanasia in case of dementia. We want to abolish the 5 year period of validity in respect of the declaration of their wish concerning euthanasia. We want all documents related to end of life available on the electronic identity card. We want a legal framework concerning the application of euthanasia in case of complete life. Thank you.